have to tell people when I'm making a joke. Sure. Sometimes.
Apple down.
Apple down. So anyway, that's a joke. There was no memo. The people wearing purple or burgundy or any shade of purple were not hand selected by me for having really high levels of awareness.
The memo.
Next year there will be a memo. So if you don't get the color the day before, you know you didn't work hard enough on your level of awareness in 2015. Putting it out there, you don't want to put any pressure on you, but you really have to pay attention this next hour if you want to get the color memo next year. Okay? We're all good? I was actually getting some downloads in the break, and I realized I have like way too much content for the remainder of this seminar. I don't know how this happens every year, but it does. So I'll try to get to the key points. And then throughout the year, come back every month on the second Wednesday of each month, and I'll give you the balance of what it is that they gave you tonight throughout the whole year. Okay? It's not actually tonight yet, is it? All right, so everybody is aware of the most important principle of the year, which is to live as though you are eternal, okay? One of the interesting pieces of information that I remember that was really, it helped me awaken back in 2012. When I was doing the 2012 seminar, it's a refill on my bottle. Thank you, Derek. Right, in 2012, when I was giving a seminar, I had never heard this before from guys, but it was a life changer for me during that seminar, and it has changed my perspective about things ever since. And one of the key principles that they gave during that year, and I'll write it on the board because it is a very, very important principle, even though if you were here in 2012, you already know it. But are as important as everything in existence, and everything in existence is as important as you. When I heard that in the 2012 seminar, it really completely changed the way I view our stay here on Earth. Because there's so many different schools of thought or ways that people are teaching people to have happy lives or to be better people, whatever it is people are teaching, but they usually focus on one of those halves of the equation. And they don't focus on both of the halves of the equation. So religion might be teaching ideas that the collective is more important than you. Or a different school of thought might be teaching that you're more important than anybody or anything. It's not true. Neither one of those is true. And if you live as though one of those two is true only, you're not living to the fullness and the richness and the possibilities of your own life. And you're not living to your full power, there's nothing on earth that could minimize the significance of you. I don't care how many people are on the planet at any given moment, or what they're doing, or what their focus is. I don't care if they're a king, or a leader, or a nurse, or a teacher. I don't care what it is you're doing. There's no comparison, because there's nothing on earth that's as important as you. And there is no one as important as you. You are as important as everything in existence. And everything in all of existence is as important as you. And when you see the balance in that, this is everything, this is you, you get your place in this world. You are important. You matter. Everything you do and think and feel and believe matters because you are as important as everything. And when you live like that, when you understand that sentence, it helps having a little bit more natural ability to live as though you know you are eternal. Because on earth, we really downgrade who we are in our minds. In the energy realm, we soar. We understand how magnificent we are. We don't compare. We don't say, oh, well, he was John Lennon, or he was Martin Luther King, or he was this person, or he was that person on earth. He must be a better soul than me. Not true. It's simply not true. It's just that we do this stacking of comparisons on earth through judgment and misunderstanding and low self-esteem. We are always categorizing how good someone is or how worthy someone is based on these teachings or ways that we live and the way we co-live. But there's nobody on this planet that is more important than you. And there's nobody in existence, no soul in existence, that is a more important soul than you. And interestingly, to show you how important you are, everything in all of existence is as important as you. It's a different way of looking at things. And it helps to shed the misbeliefs that you've picked up about anything that might make you feel small or insignificant or not having power. Because you do have power. You do have power. And again, just as though I was speaking before about this is not about you judging yourself and say I should have or I can and I didn't. This is about accepting that exactly who you are right now, in this moment, flaws, misbeliefs, whatever else you have going on in human form right now, you are just magnificent like this. Just magnificent. You're not going to become more magnificent if you save the world. You're still going to be magnificent. You might have a higher vibrational energy because you're surging if you're saving the world, but you are magnificent now. And there's no judgment in the eternal scheme of things about how much it is that you contribute to make you more worthy. So it's okay to be exactly who you are. And being exactly who you are is powerful. And when you sit in the driver's seat of your own self-love, you want to do more. You want to make your reach and your imprint more visible and more energetically significant. But it's not a feeling of sacrifice anymore when you think that you're insignificant and you have that responsibility to make things for other people better. It's more of a privilege because understanding how important you are is something that overflows. It's an abundance that just keeps moving and moving and moving. And from that is born this desire to contribute in a way that you might not have contributed before. And even contributing, there's no qualifier on what it means to contribute. If you live less than respecting yourself, others, and the planet, and you move toward a little bit more respect for yourself, others, and the planet, you're already contributing more. Just living to that respect of self, respect of others, and respect of your planet, just living to those three simple things makes you a grand contributor to our Earth life as it exists today. Anything else you want to do, it's extra. It's extra. And anything else that you want to do becomes something, like I said, that the more your self-love grows, the more you realize that you can and want to do other things. You don't live in a state of disempowerment. You start to live in a state of power, of knowing what you are and what you're capable of. One of the things that was whispered in my ear on the way here was just this word. One of the greatest things about me being able to allow my consciousness to return the state of consciousness that we were at before we were all born, to be in the energy realm, stated in human terms, to visit where we were before we had this lifetime. To be in that state, for me, it helps me understand how we all soar as souls and that there are no limits. It was very interesting. When I started to visit the energy realm, I would go with a percentage of Karen and join a percentage of my soul. So I was so used to being me. It was such a habit to be me and to see all things through my own lens that I wasn't able to just leave Karen on Earth and visit there purely through the lens of my soul. And what would happen is the more I worked on getting rid of my masks and layers, the percentage would change. So in the beginning, I was visiting like 70% Karen, 30% of my soul would be there, present in my experiences in the energy realm. Then over time, it was like 50-50, and then it was, you know, 70% of my soul, 30% of Karen. If I get myself into the right state of consciousness, a free one, I can pretty much let Karen go. I don't know what percentage I bring of her with me anymore into these opportunities, but maybe it's 10 or 20%. And when I'm there in that full state of being my soul instead of being Karen, I realized how silly I was in the beginning. When I would communicate with guides, and I would communicate with souls there, I would treat everybody as though they were more important than me. I was so little with the percentage of Karen that I brought there for this visit. I felt so meek, and I felt so inferior. And I would listen to their narrative about how important I was and how I'm just like them and I'm not better than you. And I would listen and I'd listen and I'd be like, oh, they're so sweet, they're so cute, you know, subliminal suggestions, the placebo effect. And I would have these stupid earthbound narratives with myself when I returned home thinking, they're just so kind. They really nailed the kindness thing. And listen, if you're dealing with some souls in the energy realm who were pretty well known for doing some fabulous things on Earth, it can get a little heady. So, all you know, wow, you're not even kidding, I'm communicating with this soul? Mm-hmm. So I got smaller and smaller and smaller when I would visit there than I might have even felt on Earth. But over time, my visits became more pure. I visited more from the state of my soul and could bring back those memories and having Karen visit and see how the other half lives. So being there now, I get that I am as important as everything and that everything is as important as me. I get it. I know it. I feel it. And I feel it about every soul and every experience that I'm interacting with in the energy realm. And it's a freeing feeling. It helps you to let go of everything, categorizing things, limiting things, judging people, judging experiences. All the work that you do to peel this stuff off on Earth, a few moments like that, you come back to Earth, it's like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. None of it matters. In my immediate family, I'm very, very, very difficult to live with because nobody knows what to buy me as presents. Because I really don't want anything, you know? Do I like certain things or like things that are pretty? I do. There's certain things that I like, but there's nothing that I could have that's physical that's going to make me happier than I already am. The choices I make in what my physical life is like are about comfort. In this case, it's your comfort. But in most cases, it's my comfort. And that's how I choose. And sometimes comfort means I like a pop. Like I like a pop of having my senses stimulated. So if I want something, it's because it has so many colors, or it's made of glass, or it's got a saying on it that just captivates me. And I don't hesitate to take that stuff and move them on. I got my recycling system of where things go. I don't hesitate to take them out of my space when something also pops for me. So, yeah, I know I'm difficult. And I always tell them I'm not difficult to buy for, but I know I'm really, really difficult to buy for. And that's a good thing, because I live that in a way that the material world doesn't have any hold over me anymore. And when I'm engaged in material principles, it's usually for the benefit of someone else, because I still remember that I'm a person, and I still remember that I co-create with people who share my experience with me. So when I'm seeking abundance, or I'm seeking something more material, it's usually so that I can reach more people, or so I can let my closest people have an experience where they don't feel any limits on this earth. I like to share that. I like to share the way that I feel and let them feel things too, wherever they are in their human space. So abundance for me is not, it's not a necessity. It's not something that I'm losing any sleep over. It's about what it can help me do in living in the human form, which means primarily reaching more people. So I don't mess this up. Let me grab my cheat sheet that I wrote down in a traffic light without throwing my butt out the window. This is what they gave me. When you're in the energy realm and you're not encumbered by human masks and layers, you soar. You sense your abundant reach. So for us, soar is sensing our abundant reach. Sense it. Don't just think it. Sense it. It doesn't matter what your material world is like at the second. It doesn't matter. It doesn't limit your reach. It doesn't limit your power. It doesn't limit how you can express that you are as important as everything and everything is as important as you. There are no limits when you sense your abundant reach. I have to say our for the listeners that aren't seeing this. Sensing our abundant reach. In the energy realm, when I get to know it and be it and do it, I feel it more here. And the more you practice it, the more you are igniting your ability, once again, to live as though you are eternal. Because you are eternal. And when you are in your state of not having a physical body, you are quite aware of what your abundant reach is. You know that this energy that you emit, the energy that I talked about in the beginning, that we can see demonstrated through the pendulums and the energy stick, and just by witnessing the effect that we have on other people, we understand the power of that energy. We sense its abundance. How that abundance propagates on Earth doesn't matter all that much. It can come through relationships. It can come through stuff. It can come through great health. It can come through money. But you can have any of that abundance that it is that you want when you remember that you are eternal. And you remember that as a soul, you soar. And anything less than soaring on Earth is a learned behavior and a habit that you were taught by other people, and it's not true. Stryker, what did we have up on Facebook today?
The quote from this one?
Yeah.
Give me a minute.
Because I know it's relevant. But I don't remember what it is.
I'll tell you in a second.
Random.
Yeah, something like, don't let anyone...
Oh, yeah. All
right, guys, Karen. Anyone that ever told you you are not enough was wrong.
Oh, I like that. And I get sore. Anybody who has ever told you that you are not enough is wrong. Period. Soaring is not necessarily easy to implement in your day-to-day life immediately again, like just because you heard it. Some of these ideas that they're talking about having real significance in 2015 they're very high level of awareness kinds of ideas, and not necessarily easy to just go out and live it all tomorrow. But if you listen to this over and over again, it's going to chop away at some of the stuff that's separating you from it. But what they're showing us in aggregate is two things. Here's where I say it gets complex this year. They're showing us in aggregate two things. You are as important as everything, and everything is as important as you. And live as though you are eternal. Together, what that does is it gives you an opportunity to choose to grow yourself as an individual and to be mindful of the contributions that you're giving to others. The two together are what the energy of 2015 is all about. It's about continuing to work on yourself, but also contributing more, to be a bigger player on the stage, meaning just taking some actions, big or little, to get yourself more to knowing that you are living as though you are eternal, to return yourself a little bit more to knowing that you soar, to sensing our abundant reach. So there's a very strong personal, individual component of focus in 2015, and there's a very strong, powerful component of being one, being connected to all in 2015. And in the previous years that we've done the seminar, they focused so much on your journey, your space, your day-to-day stuff. What am I having for breakfast? You know, am I cleaning my closets out? How are my relationships? How do I feel about my body? Am I in harmony? So we've worked on that stuff. For 3 years we've been working on this stuff. If you've been with me since 2007, we've been working on it for more than 3 years. Karen? we're not going to stop working on it. You know, the day-to-day stuff. Like, how do I get in harmony with my body? How do I listen intuitively to what my body wants as far as sleep and exercise and what I eat? We're going to continue all this. It doesn't go away. But this is the year. That's why I said this is a big, complex year. This is where it's not one or the other anymore, people. It's not one or the other anymore. This year is both. Everything is as important as you, and you are as important as everything. It's not about working on yourself so you can be happier day to day only, and it's not about getting yourself excited about charities and doing for others and, you know, sacrificing and donating and doing all that. It is not one or the other anymore. This is the year you get to be both, and you get to respect that you are both. And you get to be happy with being both. You are both. We all are both. So sensing our abundant reach means that we get to live in a way that we value our individual experiences and improving it, and we value our collective experience and improving that. Oh. So we talked about a little bit about maybe knowing we're eternal more in our place in the world and how we can honor and respect the collective by respecting everybody's ideas, respecting yourself, respecting people, and respecting the planet. So we talked about this in a global way, and we showed how it will affect you as a person. So it's so interesting that your guys started out today by saying something that's good for the globe, that's completely good for you too, and that completely honors your eternal nature. It shows that this partnership is what they're going to continue to help emphasize for the people in this room and for everybody on the planet. The gifts of what they're knocking on your door when today. They're knocking on the doors of everybody everywhere. It's just that most people aren't going to be aware or conscious that these are some of the themes that are arriving on their doorstep for them to open up and let in. They're just not aware. They always say you can live asleep or awake, But once you start to wake up, there's a huge spectrum in awakeness, one that never, ever ends. Because even as a soul, you're still waking and waking and waking and remembering your true self and remembering all that is. So on this planet, there's a lot of people that are completely asleep. These ideas are knocking on your door all the time. And those ideas, they knock very, 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 very hard the more asleep you are. They're much more challenging at the door. Much more challenging at the door. Because they understand that, you know, we've tried this, we've tried this, we tried that, and then we tried this, and we did a combination of that, and we knocked it this time, and we knocked here. You never opened the damn door for us. So what we're going to do this time is we're going to take something and we're going to knock that door down. You might not know what knocked the door down. You're just going to feel necessarily maybe the challenge of it all. But the knock for anyone that isn't somewhat awake already is designed to help them re-perceive things, to see things from a different angle, to start to get curious about our eternal nature, to start to get curious about how important we are, to get curious about whether we deserve happiness, to get curious about how to become more harmonious. That's what the knocks on the door are. So even though you guys are sitting here, and you don't need to get a knock on the door because you're just getting, you opened the door already, you came in, say, hey, what do you got for me? Here, tell me, bring it on, bring it on. Everyone else is going to get the same knocks this year. But how well they're able to interpret or understand the knocks will be up to every individual. And whether or not they're curious about the meaning behind the knocks will again be based on everybody's individual level of awareness when the knock comes. I always say that whomever you are, the more you're shining personally and returning to your own source, the more effect you have on the world around you, incidentally, even with you not taking any specific action, your energy alone affects others. And I believe that if you're in this room today and you're able to get these messages as the year is beginning to unfold, you're going to have more ripples that affect more people. It's like you can't even help it, right? You just can't even help it. Like someone's mumbling and grumbling at work, and they're going on and on and on about this, and you're like, oh, you know, I don't really see it that way, or, oh, I remember when that happened to me, and this is the good that came of it. And all of a sudden you're saying these things, they're coming out of your mouth, and people are becoming more and more receptive. Fascinating. For anyone that works in business right now, or they're in management, if you look at the content of the management training programs, they are jam-packed with some spiritual ideas, except no one's admitting that they're jam-packed with spiritual ideas. So you don't have to be a flake and go out there and talk like me. You don't have to make everyone,
ooh, ho,
Okay, yes, very nice, nice dress. Do that. You can use real people terms and still get the message out there. You can speak like real people speak, or at least know how to, you know, change up your audience a little based on who it is you're communicating with. But you got to find it's harder and harder to listen to someone that's knocking at your door over and over and over again with the same complaint or the same misbelief, and just keep turning a shoulder, saying, oh, do the best she can within her level of awareness. It gets harder when there's the repeat knock to just leave them in their own space. You know, everyone's doing the best that they can within their level of awareness. That's 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010, holy mackerel, 2011, 2000, all of those. You guys are living that already. You're done. You're past that. You're ready to move on to something bigger. You know everybody's doing the best they can within their level of awareness. You're not judging what people look like. You're not judging their religion. You're not judging their appearance. You're past all of that. So now, when people are knocking at your door with perhaps a lower level of awareness, repeat over and over and over again, that means that somehow one of their guides got through to them enough to suggest, with them not knowing, that they knock on your door your door. That's how this works. People who are asleep are still getting messages from God. They just don't know it. People who are a little more awake are getting messages from guides. Sometimes they're just following their curiosity or just an urge, you know? Or how many times do you hear somebody say, I don't know why I just said that? Anyone who says, I don't know why I just said that, is listening to their guide, but probably without knowing that they're listening to a guide. Living like you know you are eternal means you get that we have this eternal source that we can tap into in this journey. Intuition. Souls that love you. Souls that are guiding us. Souls that are working in partnership with us to help us move and advance in the direction that we're moving and advancing. So all of this comes together with a lot of complex stuff coming together. Living as though you know you are eternal, you do so by respecting yourself, people, all ideas, and the planet. But living as though you know you are eternal means you also accept the support that we have from eternal sources of love and guidance. So it's a two-part component. Here's where I say it gets complex in 2005. There's nothing that's just linear this year that they're talking about. It's all about the whole of our existence as a soul and how that wholeness fits into being here on this planet today. So I don't know if anybody noticed that there was a title. This is the only other phrase other than the one that they gave me. I'll give it to you in a moment. But there was a title on the CD for today's program. Who noticed it? Yeah. One person. Derek. Derek, one of the great things that Derek does is when I book this date, and Derek prepares himself, and he prepares himself a lot, and he says, can you just give me something, anything? And it's kind of cool because he asks a month or two in advance, so it makes the guides give me something. So if I show up with a word or two, and then therefore he runs with it. I don't know what he's doing with that word. So I write them down because I'm sure I'm not going to hear them again until I get here and I'm standing here. So he's got it. He could probably give this whole seminar. But the words at this time were that he gave, they gave to Derek. Power through. This helps us to capitalize on the theme of today. You are as important as everything. Everything is as important as you. And live as though you know you are eternal. Power through helps you to see your journey as an earth being and understanding that you are a powerful being and that sometimes things don't unfold the way you want them to. Sometimes they don't go as quickly as you want them to. And sometimes things go wrong. Sometimes things are scary and you might be afraid or you might feel limited or you might feel less than. But you can power through it because you are unlimited. You are eternal. You are as important as everything. So you can power through those moments of feeling less than. And I'm going to give you the tool that they had us building for 2 days. I'm going to give you the tool next. But I'm going to give you a tool to just help you with powering through. All right? You have a goal. You have a lot of goals. Some of them are clear for you. Some of them are not clear to you. But powering through helps you to focus on getting to the goals that it is that you set. It helps you to remember that you can do it. If you set a goal of any kind, professionally, personally, relationship-wise, anything, if you set a goal, there's going to be a lot of times when you doubt your ability to get there, and there's going to be times when you lose focus or you lose energy or you lose encouragement or you get plain old scared. There's going to be a lot of times that that stuff happens and you want to give up on the goal or you just slowly let the goal fade from your mind because it's an easier way of not having to find your power within rather than to say, I can find a way to amplify energy. I can find a way to power through. So this year, whether you're doing little things or big things, if your focus simply, your choice simply this year is to live as though you know you are eternal, if you get yourself into a circumstance and you're like, wow, I am so not proud of how I handled that, it's not about crawling back into yourself and feeling unworthy. It's about powering through. You power through it. You say, here's what I did. Here's what I would have preferred to do. Are there any actions that I can take to leave the circumstance, close this chapter in a better way than I had left it at this moment? You power through it. You power through it. Don't just leave it. Power through it. There's something you can do. Just power through it. Now, suppose my goal is that I'm so underappreciated at my job and I don't like what I'm doing anyway. And for 5 or 6 years now, I've been talking about having my own business. And here's what I want to do. And so all of a sudden, the here's what I want to do, you're explaining it to someone, and it's 45 minutes later, and some of the other person's like, that sounds like a really good idea. Maybe you should just do it, right? And you're like, oh, well, here's the bus again that we throw out the window. I can't because, but I thought I would, but, and then I couldn't do it, but, you know. All the buts start to come out, and we don't necessarily do it. But you can power through. Even if it's a moment where you're changing your goal a little because fear was overwhelming for you or something else was overwhelming, at least be aware and conscious that you're changing your goal and change your goal to meet where you have stepped up your power to. Okay? So, for example, I want to lose 25 pounds this year and I make this decision mid-October, right? Come around January 2nd, I'm like, oh, those holidays and all the food and the drinking and, you know, this has been horrible. And then the whole year, you're like shot. You're not planning on doing anything anymore. Well, just because you didn't lose a bit of that 25 pounds in that 2 months doesn't mean that you can't get up on January 3rd or January 20-something. You can't get up on January 24th and just power through. And remind yourself that you are a soul having a human experience. Any limit in your ability to meet your goal was caused by someone else indicating that you were less than. You're not less than. You are powerful. You can do anything that you want. So if that number 25 sounds scary because you already failed, but that's for listeners, that's an exclamation point. It's not such a thing as failure. If that's overwhelming, then say, you know what, I'm going to lose 12. Wow, 12 pounds, I should be able to do that by March. That's not that hard, right? It's doable now. And then you power through it. On a day-to-day basis, you use the tools that are at your fingertips and you power through it. You power through it. You use those tools. We have talked about more tools in the last number of years than I can even count. And the tools just keep coming and coming. And I watch clients use the tools all the time. The tools are there because they work. The tools work. That's why we use that. We're not very good at solving our issues within our mind, especially if the problem arose in the mind. And the tools help us to power through what we think might be a setback. And to do so, to power through means that you're tapping into the power that you have inside of you. It's not about self-judgment and saying, I really messed up. I can't believe how much I ate over the holidays, or I've been talking about this for 6 years and I haven't done it yet. Power through means just take a step now. Even if you have to downgrade the goal a little bit, when you reach that goal or when you get closer and closer to it, trust me, you're going to increase it again. But get yourself enough energy and momentum in that direction so that you can increase the goal. Don't make some goal so unreachable that you can't take any steps to get to it. And then when you reevaluate what your goal is, power through it. Use your tools. Power through it. So as an individual, power through is about your...
AL.
And it's going to be about powering through you, using your power to move things, using your power to get things going again, using your power to know that you can change something if it's not going the way that you want it to. But remember we said that you are as important as everything and everything is as important as you? And do you remember that we said to live as though you know you are eternal? Power through is also about our eternal nature. Because as you're working on living a life that's happier for you as an individual and becoming more mindful of being in that space where everything is as important as you, the power can come through you too. We are eternal. There are sources of guidance that are helping us, whether you know it or not, or you accept it or not. Those sources can come through you with power. All you have to do is ask and intend and appreciate. When you ask and you intend and you appreciate, then you become more aware in the physical that this power comes through you. What good does it do us if we know we are eternal? And then all the other eternal powers that be, all that other magnificent resources that's available to us in the non-physical, what good is it if we just leave it alone and do all of our powering through on our own? And we think we have to go it alone. We don't have to go it alone. We don't have to go it alone at all. We can allow the power of the assistance that is non-physical to come through us. And in what I thought was a really long seminar, 3 hours, turned out to be a really short seminar because I have so much other things. But in a 3-hour seminar, I can't tell you exactly how to tap into that power. But look through my intuition development stuff. Look through the essays on my website. You know, have a session, come to a group, join a private group, create a private group. You know, there are ways that you can tap into your eternal sources of love and guidance, and you can do so in a way that you know it in your hands, you know it in your being, okay? All right, let's go to the power through earthly tool. I'm going to give you, I really do love acronyms because they really help us to remember things, okay? In order to power through, here's a tool that you can use all year. And it's a bit of a gem. Who knows where I'm going next? All right, come on, guys. Go through your head. Come on, figure it out. What's the acronym? We're talking about power through.
Momentum.
What was I? Gain
enough momentum.
Oh, I like that. All right, we're going to have more than one then. Gain enough momentum. That's pretty cool. What the guides had given me for this is get energy moving. Get energy moving. If nothing is going on, nothing is happening, nothing will ever happen. There will be no change if you don't participate in the change. So powering through means don't just sit there and say, oh, I wish, or oh, I didn't make it, or oh, I'll never do it, or oh, I can, or but. Get your energy moving. Get your energy moving. And the tool that we have created is a series of a little different than what you would see as a typical affirmation that we have been using. I was last year the I am year?
No, 2013.
Freedom.
Freedom?
Freedom, yeah.
Hearing what?
Okay. Oh, fear, right. All right, so the I am statements were helping you to find the power within you. You were asked to look at those dozens and dozens of I am statements that they gave you. You were asked to pick the 5 that you wanted to focus on for that particular year and to keep them with you, because the 5 that you chose were the ones that were true about you but that you forgot were true about you. So I am courageous, I am strong, I am I am happy, I am healthy. Whatever one in that particular year escaped you, you were asked to pick the five that were escaping you, and then you were given tools to use those five statements throughout the year to help you remember something that you forgot about yourself. So the gems this year are not necessarily going to be related only to helping you find the power within you that you forgot, but it is more geared toward getting energy moving. It's going to be used as a way to make sure that you are in it, you're in the game, okay? You don't have to keep reviewing the past all the time. You don't have to keep looking at what you're lacking. You don't have to keep saying, I did it, I can't. You can actually just start right now to move toward your goals, and you can find different ways to power through. And these gems are gems that you can use on a daily basis to help you with powering through. And almost always, guides will try to provide you with something physical. And as I explained, if you were like at getting it right, having a physical something helps you to take the process of your action out of your head and gives you a stimuli so that you can recall what it is you intended to do. All right? So this tool is the physical one for you to look at this year that can be a reminder of how to tap into these gems to help you power through what it is that you want to focus on. So I'm going to read them to you. There's 16. You don't have to write them down. You'll memorize them the second I say them. I feel really good about that. All right, the first gem, I promise you, Miffy's in writing. The first gem, it was okay to procrastinate yesterday, but today I am fully charged. The step I take today may seem small, but all my small steps quickly add up. The universe is my partner in creating my reality. I know I am not alone. Any of these helpful to anyone yet? What's 16 minus 3? That one I can do. All right, we got 13 to go. Okay, 13 more. So you're going to have some with gems this year? The power that I have surges through me. Today, I will take one inspired action toward my goals. I know I can do it. I know I can do it. Today, I will sense 3 whispers from the universe encouraging my choices. Today, I will sense 3 whispers from the universe encouraging my choices. Round number 8. It's amazing how confident I feel. I feel the excitement of getting closer to my goal. I have courage. No matter how I might have felt in the past, I know that I am capable and talented. The solution will reveal itself. Every day does not have to be an on day. When I feel off, I know that my energy from other days is still creating what I want. That one was personal for Victoria. Thanks for showing up, Victoria's guide. I believe you were there at 6 o'clock on Thursday. Why not me? deciding to follow my dreams. I think she was a little slow in answering, why not me? And last but not least, the last gem of the day. Everything is aligning perfectly. We have goodies. I need a few helpers.
Because you're writing so fast. I think we can.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm good. And if anybody mentions the fact that there are two razor cuts on the front, we will talk afterwards. Seriously, talk. So let us not judge the superfluous razor mark. Let's pretend it has a benefit that we might not be aware of at the moment.
That was every day doesn't have to be a good day.
Okay, no, no, I take all that back. I take all that back. When I finally have someone step up and say, I have a manufacturer for all these goofy things you've been producing over the years, I will have them manufactured without the extra line. Okay. I still haven't had anyone step up and say, I have a manufacturer for you. All right, so this is, it's very self-explanatory. Just choose in the morning what it is that you're feeling, you're needing to power through whatever's going on in your life that day. And having it be visible and having 16, what I think are really cool choices of what can help you power through, is going to help you to gear into gaining enough momentum.
Brilliantly said.
Who was that? So in this year, this is your personal journey. There's going to be a lot of things that you're still wanting to shift about you as an individual. Lots of masks and layers that you're going to want to release still. So you're not going to stop all of that, but you're also going to understand that this is a year of moving forward. This is a year to stop saying when. This is a year when you don't have to buy every spiritual self-help book on the shelf and read and read and read. You had enough books already, but the next one I'm writing. Let's move the energy. That was all practice. So this year is the year that you say, I'm not going to spend as much time analyzing. I'm not going to spend as much time philosophizing. Is that a word? I'm not going to spend as much time, you know, thinking about it, mulling it over, and saying, oh, what about this? Oh, well, when I was 7. Oh, well, look what happened when I was 37. You know what? You've been doing all of that stuff. You really want to be doing that for the rest of your life? Why not just move forward? Why not get your energy moving in the direction of where you want to be? Because as an eternal being, the more you move your energy in where you want to be, the more you're respecting everybody, yourself, the entire planet, and the more you are living as though you know you are eternal. So we're going to power through, take our daily gem, and get our energy moving. This is the year to get your energy moving. Now, I know I gave you a lot of information today and a lot to remember, which I think is very, very helpful that this is recorded so that you can get the CDs and listen and remember things. You know, you might not be able to work on something we spoke about at 2:30 right now, or maybe 1:20, or maybe 3:30. But work on the little bit that's got you jazzed up right now. Work on that element, and that's enough for now. But then listen to what other things your guides were telling you about the energy of this year, and then start something else when you feel like you've really mastered the one that you began, or you feel you've made strides in the one that you began, that you got the energy moving in the one that got you the most excited from the suggestions that were made today. Be happy with your progress. Don't criticize your progress, because half of what it is that we're talking about is to understand that you are a soaring soul and you have no limits, and that you are a powerful being. And anything that's telling you that you are less than is false. So accept where you are as you're moving in progression toward all of the suggestions that were made for you today. But don't judge if you're not at any one of them or all of them in any given moment. Because you never, ever intended to be in some state of completion. We are never complete. We're always moving. If you're getting your energy moving, if you're living to the best of your ability and understanding that you are eternal, and if you're accepting the powerful truth that you are as important as everything, and everything is as important as you, you are already there. You are already there. Now, what I want to end with today, if you open these up, you can do it now. I'll give you a moment to wrestle. One person has two of the same strips. One person. If you are the one with two of the same strips. I have the extra strip for you, so you'll have the full 16. And you get a free product today when you need it.
Yeah.
I do.
You do?
Yay.
What?
Congratulations, Amory.
Come on, Amory. Get your trip. Come
on.
Woo!
Run, run.
Into the water of humanity to get the whole globe moving into a direction of having an increased level of awareness. And we talked about tons and tons and tons and tons of ways that you in your personal space, your personal life, can have that be happier. You deserve to be happy. You deserve to be happy. You deserve to be happy. Okay? So we talked about that a lot. And the other thing that is a theme that's running through everything that we have done in all of these years, just how much is 2015 minus 7.
Eight.
Right? 8 years. So, yeah, 8. So today's the 8th year anniversary of me doing this. In addition to all that, we've talked a lot about intuition. It's been through everything we've spoken about. Intuition is our source to connecting in a knowing way with our eternal existence, with guides, with sources of power that are supporting us and helping us. Intuition is a pathway for us to tap into that energy that's there for us all the time anyway. So we've talked about how can you help harmonize your life. We've talked about developing your intuition, and we've talked about the value of being a ripple of benefit on this planet that it is that we live on. But what it is we keep talking about them separately. But what I want to show you today is how it all comes together in 2015. That if you have this basic knowingness, and you tap into this basic knowingness and understanding, pulling all of these ideas together, you're going to be on the inside track of the energy for 2015. So you're not going to be the one smashing into brick walls trying to figure out what the heck is going on. You're going to be the one that is able to navigate smoothly and happily and peacefully, continuing to increase your level of awareness with more and more knocks at your door coming from happy and peaceful things that help you to increase your level of awareness and not needing the hard knocks of the challenges. So just understand this. Three components all together in understanding your own power. One is all of the earth. You are as important as everything, and everything is as important as you. The second is you are powerful as an individual. You are as important as everything. The eternal is the power that comes through us, connecting with our sources of non-physical guidance, tapping into the truth about us being eternal, not just being rhetoric, but experiencing the eternal in our day-to-day lives. This whole trilogy is what helps us to have a great, unlimited life, and it also helps us to become the best at putting ripples of goodness and greatness, good energies into the waters of humanity while we are living here. So it's not just a double partnership, it's a triple partnership. And all three components are equally necessary. The power that you know that you matter. The power of the collective to understand that the collective is as important as everything and everything is as important as you. less, that we are not alone. We are eternal. Live like you are eternal in your day-to-day life, respecting yourself, respecting others, and respecting your planet, and understand that as you are doing this respectful thing and knowing that we are eternal, the eternal knowledge doesn't stop there. It continues as the source of our eternal love and guidance keeps coming through us with power. I told you this is a complex year. So it's a lot to take in, but it's all there for you.
Did you intentionally write individual on the outside, all of Earth going through, and eternal on the inside?
No, that's a left-hand, right-hand thing.
Well, what's the first step of what you drew?
What I wanted. I wanted to write them all the way around the circle and continuous, but I'm not able to do that. So think of them being more like, here's one word, here's one word, here's the other. That's what it should be like. Okay, inside, out, doesn't matter. But they're all equivalent. And the power through, the power of the individual and the power of the collective, see this as the arrows that are moving the whole sphere, keeping things moving in a positive direction. So power through is the power that you have as an individual, and the power that comes through you from your eternal nature and from the forces that are guiding you. And I listened to what guides brought through today, and to me, it sounds like that's everything. That's all we got. You know, there's nothing more. What more is there after that, right? That's it. That's everything. So I don't know what we're going to do in 2016. So, you know, we may have like a potluck dinner. We may have kumbaya with Darren. I don't know what we're going to do. But this is it. This is what you need to know in order to have the best and happiest and richest and fullest life that you can possibly have on Earth. All right? And all the other stuff, it's just the pieces, it's just the tools, it's just the choices. You can always find a tool. You can always find a choice. You can always find a gem of the day. You can always find an affirmation. You can always find a conduit to your guide. You can always find a source. You can always find stuff. But when you're recognizing the big picture, the context of it all, then at least you'll have a good understanding of the canvas on which you are painting this reality. The other thing is, like I said, I really don't know what's going to happen in 2016, and trust me, I'm not going to think about it until a week before, I really don't. But I can tell you one thing that I feel really pretty confident about in listening to guides today. There's a lot of content here. It's complex, but this is a significant year. This is not just one of those years that's going to be whispering, saying, I keep using it as a metaphor because it's a really good metaphor, but, you know, clean out a drawer, empty a closet, get rid of someone that's not in your space of making you feel loved anymore. It's not just a little knock on the window, you know. It's more than that this year. This is a very significant year energetically. I think we're going to see a lot of surprises on the planet, meaning that whatever challenges are being faced by people in the globe, they're going to have a huge variety this year. It's not going to be the same kind of incident over and over again. It's going to be a variety, because it's variety that speaks to all different people. One person might get a thought or an insight from a storm. Another one might get it through a war. Another person might get something that's happening in Paris. Another person might see a homeless. Another one might volunteer at an animal shelter. But the incidents this year are going to be filled with such vivid variety to give as many people on Earth the possibility of opening the door that's knocking. Opening the knock on the door. So we will see a huge amount of variety, but at least keep the incidents in context that you're witnessing outside of you, understanding that they have this really amazing collective value and collective purpose. Okay? And that's, my friends, 2015. Have any questions before we go?
Is there a way that you can just like clarify the knock on the door so when the people that are listening to the audio, they can get a sense of it?
A knock on the door is that because we do have this eternal partner, we do have the energy of the universe that's helping to move us in the direction of making improvements and changes that are valuable. If you are asleep or you're unaware of something and you forgot something that you knew when you were born, a knock on the door is a way to help you reconceive or re-perceive whatever it is you're focusing on. So an easy example to take it in is that if you have a heart attack, when you're recovering in the hospital, you might start to think about your life a little bit differently. You might start to reevaluate your priorities. You might start to think, maybe I should work less or do more of this, or maybe I didn't do this. The reevaluation period is the result of the knock on the door. The disharmony of the body was the knock, and the evaluation and implementing some kind of benefit is taking the opportunity that was knocking on your door. Okay? Any others?
This goes back to kind of maybe the first probably 45 minutes, but you were talking about how you can change your behavior based on the knowledge of how others are perceiving. And I guess part of things that I feel like I come across are I don't always feel that I'm being perceived the way I want to be perceived. And so you get into a situation where you think you're having an effect in one way, but it turns out that those that are perceiving you get a completely different message.
Yeah.
And so you mean well, but how do you feel like, I found a lot of times I'm not perceived the way
you intended. Your question is a little bit different than what the intention was with the statement about you can change your behavior based on what you think other people are perceiving you at. That part of today's topic was specifically geared towards people who are behaving not from the vibration of love, who are continually doing something that is egregious or way below the line or harmful to others or to themselves. So sometimes you can change the behavior because if you're concerned about how other people are viewing you, right? So like if I were at that traffic light and I was not on the left side and there was a car next to me, I'm not going to take my tray of cigarettes out and dump it because I'm going to be caring about what the guy next to me thinks. So I modify my behavior. And then if it turns out that the universe is helping to direct me always be in the right-hand lane at every traffic light, every long traffic light then, and maybe I'll be like, wow, it actually felt good not to dump or I might get to my next location and say, I didn't get to dump these at the traffic light because of the annoying guy in the car next to me, and I might take it out and put it in the garbage. So my perception of others' perception of me can amp up my ability to operate and tap in more from above the line choices. Okay? What you're talking about, this can be a seminar in itself, and I know we'll talk about it at making your tomorrow seminar. But it's about how do you get to the point where other people's opinions don't affect you in a negative way. All right, that's very different. What we're talking about is how can others' opinions affect you in a positive way. How do you get to the point where others' opinions don't affect you in a negative way? Okay, which is different. So,
I'm not really, I don't feel like I'm as concerned about what others' opinion is of me. It's just in retrospect, a lot of times I realize that their perception of how I perceive myself is way off.
Yeah, and that's it's really not uncommon. It's not an uncommon phenomenon. Everybody's looking through their own lens of reality, and all of the complexities that made up their journey is going to help them to interpret whatever it is that you're doing. And also, the lens coming through the eyes of someone with a lower level of awareness than you might have in any given moment is oftentimes can be a little harsher if they haven't worked on their own esteem needs. If they have a sense that you're at a place where they would like to be, they might experience the sensation of jealousy or I'm not enough. And if they accept that whatever it is you're doing or what you're being is where they would prefer to be, you're holding a mirror up to where they are. So it's easier for them to judge you incorrectly than to look at themselves and say, that's a different way of being that I might want to try, all right? We are very protective of our identities, like when we were talking about politics. You know, it's so important that people believe that you are seeing things the way that they do or living the way that they live, and the less self-esteem that they have, the more they're going to be wanting you to be like them and their choices, because it gives them permission to be enough and to be worthy in the space that they are. Okay?
My question was based on that, and you just touched upon it. When you deal with an egotistical person on a daily basis, as opposed to a politician, and you...
What's the difference?
And you know it's due to self-esteem, like you said, low self-esteem. And they really want you to agree with the way they do things, but you don't. Are you better off just keeping your mouth shut or telling them you don't agree or just agree?
I always, you know, what Dawn is asking is if you happen to have one person with an ego in your life, let you think and feel and believe and look and act like them, and you keep trying to say that that's not my cup of tea or I don't agree or whatever, what do you do then? My feeling is you follow the policy of be kind first, be kind first, be kind first. And after what feels energetically like enough be kind first, then you're being kind first to yourself if you don't engage in it, okay? So I always say attempt to make better the circumstance that you have, and if they're unwilling to, you know, meet you or cooperate in conversation or communication, then it's more important that you're watching out for yourself at that moment, okay? Just so everybody knows, it is after four.
Okay. Just on the thought that you were on, say you remove yourself from that situation or that type of person when the incident keeps going on after you've been kind many times, and then a person keeps reaching out to you. Is that them trying to reach for you for a reason, or do you just say, it doesn't matter what your reason is, if it's your guide telling you to call me?
Yeah. If you have kind of done the graceful thing to try to let somebody exit from your life, and they keep coming back and it's unclear, it probably means that you haven't had one particular incident that would let them know on some level that this is the choice that you made. And I know it's not an easy thing to do, but when that happens, sometimes it is going to be an important thing to do to give a little bit of an explanation, okay? A lot of times it can just be about talking about what the focus of your life is, so it's not about a criticism of them. So they don't feel necessarily rejected, but that more it's that your life has a course that's different than where your life was with them. All right, but you don't want to have to keep managing every incident as it comes up without having some way of kind of letting them understand that you have changed your direction. For some people that are in our lives, if they're much, much, much more challenging and you've given them some real opportunities to shift, the exit can be a little bit more dramatic in just that you have stated your intention softly and kindly, you've stated your intention more directly, and over a long course of asking them to be, you know, in a mutually beneficial relationship with you that they're unable to do. And at some point you say, listen, here's how I choose to live my life. There's no one in my life at all that treats you the way that you treat me. And, you know, I've been working on this for so long, trying to help you to understand that this is how I want to be treated. And I'm going to try to help you be like that for me, but I'm going to tell you that at some point I will walk away if it doesn't shift. You choose your own language, and that would be, you know, difficult to choose the language, but you do make it clear that I really am entitled to have, I'm entitled to have my life by choice, okay? And it also is not about one fiery move when you say, I can't stand what you did for the last 7 years. I like helping someone to come up to whether or not they have the curiosity to shift or to communicate or to understand you. Give them the opportunity a little bit more directly to join you in your space for what it is that's beneficial to you. All right?
I just wanted to ask, do we choose our guides or do our guides choose us?
It's a combination. We're guided by the same souls that we journeyed with while we were in the energy realm.
The world light?
Yes, 100% unconditional love. There is no source of negative energy that is not in, in a physical form. Okay?
4 o'clock.
All right, everybody. If anybody wants to pre-order 2015, there's a sign-up fee of $25.
So that's what I'm going to get.